See, there's a small mini train here.
Hospital is there, hospital.
Yes,
gas station. Gas station.
Okay, here down.
Garden.
Science center.
All right.
There's an industry or a factory.
Here you have
garden.
Market. Pool.
Exhibition was also
Destination
there.
Gas center.
Exhibition is also there. Giant wheel.
There's an exhibition. And you have a small road here. See, tire center. Can you see that?
Gas station.
Yeah. See, there's a road.
Gas station.
The vehicle stand is also there. There's a long walk there. Main road, madam. Main road, sub roads. Yes.
The signal, can you see signal?
The signal.
Yes. A road
or signal.
What is this vehicle standing in front of the hospital?
Ambulance.
Yes. Ambulance.
There are tents here. Can you see?
Tents.
There is a fire station.
Yes. Now, can you see this hand moving, this icon?
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, the red dot.
Okay. I'll just point out at certain things. You tell me what
is this.
What is this?
Chair.
Relaxing chair.
Easy chair. Coconut trees.
Gas stations.
Palm trees. These two.
There are number of fruit trees, madam.
Christmas trees.
And what is this?
Giant wheel. Bench.
Okay. Now, please, you all of you.
Hospital.
Okay. Now, what you're going to do is. Any one person?
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
What?
Is that a road or a parking slot, madam, between the center and the gas station? Tire center and the gas station?
Looks like a road.
I think. No, ma'am. There are some zigzag lines. So I think it must be a parking area.
There is zebra crossing.
See, there are cars here, or maybe they all belong to one part here. There's a tire center, and then there's
parking place, ma'am. That's
parking place, ma'am. This is a parking place.
Parking lot,
it may be.
Yeah, because there is no connection here, so it is not leading onto the road.
Underground road. Maybe underground what road?
No. This is a parking lot. See, there are lines here. They're all supposed to park.
Parking marks are there, no? Clearly.
Yes. That is the parking lot.
Yes.
Because it ends here, clearly. Okay. Now, who will be the stranger and who will be the local person here?
I will be the stranger.
Don't say I. Everybody is saying I. I need the name.
Karnalata.
The local person.
Shri Devi Swarnalata. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, fine. I will ask. Okay. Excuse me, ma'am. Could you please tell me the way to circus?
Sir, where are you, ma'am, just now?
Right now, near the pond, ma'am.
Right now?
Yeah.
Right now, you are near the pond.
How to reach the circus place, please?
You have to come right and take, come along the road. On the left of your,
left side,
you will have the circus.
Oh, thank you, ma'am. Okay, I have reached the circus place, please. Would you please tell me the way to tire center?
No, that's in tire center.
No,
you asked tire center or circus in the beginning?
In the beginning, circus only. That's why I told thank you. Okay, I reached the circus
no, place. Again,
okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am.
Fine. Okay, anyone else? Any other pair?
I'm standing at school. How can I reach the hospital? Can you please guide me?
Right now, where are you, ma'am?
I am at the school.
Okay. Where is it? I'm viewing from the mobile, so it is so small.
Okay.
You asked for hospital, is it? Okay. If you are, can you see a signal over there?
Yes. Next to the school.
Yeah, yes. You could see a signal, right?
Yes.
From there, you take a right turn. Again, left turn.
Okay.
If you cross the market, you will find again a right turn.
Okay.
Yeah, after crossing that, once you take a right turn, that will be a hospital.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Okay. No junction, nothing. One left or something.
Yeah, left, right,
go right.
Left, that's it.
Right. Okay.
Yes. No junctions are there, in fact.
See, when you're good. Good job, both the pairs.
Thank you.
Now, when you're giving directions, yes, some of you asked clearly where exactly you are. And some of you, on your own, you said you're standing here, you're standing there. But when you're talking on the phone, that is when you're asking, no? Where exactly are you? So here you need to be very, very specific. When you're standing outside the school, what do you see to the left? Because sometimes when you look at this picture, I may be standing here, but I may be facing that side. School is a big area. I may be standing here, I may be looking at the school, or I may be showing my back to the school. And if you say, take left and keep walking, then the person may end up going the other side. So you should first ask, are you
the facing landmark. The
school? Yes. Are you facing the school, or are you standing against the school there? What do you see to your right? What do you see to your left? Or do you see a road in front of you? Okay, then don't take that road. Take a right turn or take a left turn wherever you need to go. Okay? So that is how one needs to be very careful when you're giving directions. Because when you're standing next to each other, you can easily guide by showing hands. Just go straight like this, take a left turn or take a right turn. But over the phone, it's very difficult. You may be under the impression that the person is also visualizing scene as you see. But many times it doesn't happen. Now another person said, I'm near the pond. A pond is how big the pond is. Pond could be here. You may be standing this side, here, or the other side of the pond. This side is also a pond, right? So you should ask, okay, what do you see in there in the pond? Because that's the reason there are so many landmarks. Then the person may say, I'm near the palm trees, or I'm near the bridge. Or if you're near the pond, this also is near the pond. I'm near the factory, or near the two Christmas trees, or there's one single Christmas tree here on this side, or not the big one, the small one. So that is how you give some addresses. Okay, when you are asking, you will have to give them proper landmarks, otherwise the person may get misguided by your own information. And then you can lead on to the person. It saves a lot of time, your energy, and patience also. All right. So if you're near the pond, you can say, I'm near the beach umbrellas, there are tents. Don't say hot air balloon and the boat, because these things move off. So talk about permanent fixtures. All right. Now how was this activity? Can you conduct this in your schools? I'm sure many of you have already been doing
it.
Yeah,
sure,
we can conduct.
Bring in something very interesting, very easy. Yes, this kind of picture, it's so colorful and nice, isn't it? You can do it on the board also. You can just draw, play.
Very useful.
Yes, you can do that. You can just put a plain map on the board. You can ask children come and fill it up also and make it colorful. Come on, you draw a pond here. You draw some ducks here. You draw roads. Another person draw write signals there. All that you can do. But if you have this kind of a thing also, especially when you're doing online classes, these things are very, very helpful. You can zoom out, zoom in, and bring it. Makes the class very lively here. Okay, so anything colorful attracts the eye. Now, didn't you feel it nice? Instead of just showing some plain Okay, now we'll move on to another.
You can use the, the activity in the classroom by using the chat.
Yes. Okay, now we'll move on to another interesting thing. Listening to details. All right. Now, I'll make you listen to a railway announcement and then we'll have a discussion. Now, you're not going to talk and please remain muted, all of you. And don't write down any points. When you listen to the information, just listen. Let me share it. I'll ask you whether you're able to hear. Okay, only after that I'll start.
It's not audible, ma'am.
Can you? What did I tell you just now? Please listen carefully.
Railway now.
Okay, you able to hear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, okay.
Railway announcement. May I have your attention, please? The train number 17309 Yashwantpur Vasco Express will arrive at platform number 8 at 10:30 a.m. instead of 9 a.m. Inconvenience is regretted.
Once more. Okay, what do you hear now?
Railway announcement.
Mainly, it is telling about the delay of the train.
Delay of the train and the inconvenience it causes.
So it is informing the delay of the train.
1 hour delay. 1 and a half hour.
Excuse me.
Is everybody on mute or am I not listening to?
Were you able to hear?
Yes, madam. Yes, madam. Your voice is audible.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes. Okay, good. Do you want to listen to it once more?
Yes,
yes, do you want to hear it once again, Asit?
Yes, ma'am.
That wouldn't be necessary, ma'am, actually.
Okay. Now, what information did you get?
Regarding delay of late train, sir.
Yashwantpur,
from Yashwantpur to Vasco.
Okay.
The number of the train.
Is the train on time or is it delayed?
Train number.
It is delayed.
It is delayed.
It is delayed.
What is the name of the train?
Yashwantpur.
Yashwantpur Vasco.
Yashwantpur.
All right. And what's the number
of the
train?
17309.
Okay, now I'll ask one person, try to frame a properly worded question. We'll have between ladies and gents now. It's like a quiz. Okay, a lady is going to ask the gentleman any question. Let me see how you're going to ask. So one person, please.
Can I, ma'am? Bharti.
Bharti. Okay, start, Bharti.
Please go on.
Okay, tell me the train number.
The train number is 17309, ma'am.
All right. Is it
okay? What is the actual time?
Wait. Now we'll give chance to the men. Any male person can ask a question. So you both get one.
Okay. Is there any delay?
Yes.
What's your name? Please see your name and then start. Srivira, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Is there any delay in what?
In arrival of Yashwantpur Express.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
1 hour delay. Yes, sir. Dhyana.
Okay.
My name is Sridevi.
Okay, another question.
What is the name of the lady?
Wait. Veena. I can see Veena's name here. Veena, please ask a question.
Okay, how many hours, in which time the train came there?
In which time the train came there? Did the train come already? No, that's a wrong question, Veena.
Ma'am, may I?
Somebody try now. Asha, try.
Yes. On which platform is this Yashwantpur train expected to come?
Okay, good.
8th platform. Platform number 8.
When a lady asks, the gentleman is...
So you gents have to ask.
Platform number 8. Platform number 8.
It's a race on platform number 8.
Platform number 8. Okay. Okay, last question by the gentleman now. Yes.
What is the name of the train?
What is the name of the train? Okay.
The name of the train is Yashwantpur Express.
Is it correct?
Yes,
oh, that doesn't make sense at all. When the passenger is asking, he must be knowing the name of the train. Usually they are curious about if there is any delay in the train arrival.
Is the name of the train correct?
What is the name of the train? Yeah, that is the correct question.
Is it?
Yes.
No, correct answer?
The train's name is Yashwantpur Vasco.
What answer did your friend give now?
Straight away, the name of the train, Yashwantpur Vasco.
Express name.
She mentioned Yashwantpur.
Yes, she didn't give the complete answer. You should listen to the answer.
Yeah.
Yashwantpur,
yeah. Okay.
After asking the question. Got it.
So you lose half mark there, ladies. The men were able to answer all the questions correctly. Okay. Fine.
Okay.
Yes.
Nice one.
Yes. So how was this quiz activity now?
Nice, ma'am.
It's nice,
exciting.
Ma'am.
Exciting, ma'am.
Nice, ma'am.
Nice, ma'am.
Actual classes we can conduct quiz, we understood, ma'am.
Pardon?
In virtual class also we can conduct quiz like this, that thing we understood now.
Yes, yes. Good. In fact, in this big blue button, you have breakout rooms also, you know. I can put you in different groups. But then the problem is this group will not know what the other group is doing. So this general group is nice. Now, whenever you're dealing with, yeah, you can have competitions here. We can have state-wise competitions also. Because the beginning of the class, I could hear many of you talking about, sir, your class state 2, this state 2, that state 2. So, we can have Karnataka versus Kerala. Yes, Kerala versus Andhra, Andhra versus Puducherry versus Telangana, and all this, we can keep having that.
Okay.
Yes. The state-wise, Lakshadweep hasn't joined here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anybody from Lakshadweep? No. Okay. When you're talking about listening comprehension, we usually go in three stages. Now, what are those three stages?
Madam, listening,
one is
and comprehending and responding. Listening, comprehending and responding.
Concentration.
From listening, understanding and comprehending.
Madam, comprehending is itself understanding, na?
Yes. So we have.
So after comprehension, we have to respond for that.
I'll give you the stage, then you will get to know what I'm asking you. If I give you the first stage, I'm sure you'll give the next two stages.
Okay, ma'am.
Have you heard of this word?
Receiving, ma'am, first one.
Pre listening, listening, post listening.
Yeah, exactly. So we have pre-listening, we have post-listening, and then we have anything in
between? Pre-listening, listening, pre-listening, listening, post-listening.
Okay, so instead of just saying listening, we can say while listening.
While listening.
All right, now quickly tell me what you do in the pre-listening stage.
We pay attention to what we are going to listen.
Motivation. Exactly. You motivate and then it is a sort of an introduction. So connecting the initial part.
Concentration towards the
actual theme.
Pre-activity, any kind of.
Yes. Yeah, all your warm-up activity, ringa roses, all that will be over.
Right.
Yeah. Please mute. All of you mute. I'll quickly tell you things and please don't disturb now. So It is something like after you finish all your warm-up activities, you want to slowly link them to the theme. So you are coming here from a very wide area. It is something like this. You're coming from a very wide area. It is like an inverted pyramid. All right. So you are asking children lots of questions of whatever they already know. Now, since you're all high school teachers, you know the maxims of teaching that you learned in your B.Ed. And probably forgotten also. Now, I'll just try to make you recall whatever you've learned. Some simple maxims of teaching. What are those? Like simple to complex, known to unknown. Anything else?
Easy to difficult.
Very good. Then?
Indirect to unknown.
Familiar to unknown.
Yes.
Direct to indirect.
Concrete and abstract. Indirect to methods.
Known to unknown.
Example to rules.
Examples to rules, good.
Learning by doing.
Okay, no.
Learning by doing.
From this to that, this to that. Concrete to abstract.
Particular to general.
Prescriptive and.
So you're coming from, mute now. So you're coming from a wide area, whatever the child is familiar with, you build a rapport. You must have heard this word, R-A-P-P-O-R-T. We develop a kind of a rapport with the children so that they're able to comprehend better. They're going to feel comfortable when they're participating in the class. Okay? So simple questions. Now, for this railway announcement, what could be your pre-listening activity?
Attention, please.
Okay. You come from a very wide area. Your attention and all that is somewhere here.
So keep quiet.
Normal talk, what we do?
Some interesting
We give them information about the railway station.
Okay, and even before talking about railway station, can you go further backwards?
Yeah, we will ask the children to name any means of transport.
Okay, fine. You can ask them different means of transport, or you can show them pictures of modes of transport. Okay, I hope you are able to hear. Or you can make them listen to different sounds of vehicles. So slowly, whatever the child is familiar with, you're going from there. Or if you want to have a discussion, you can talk to the children and say, children, what do you do during holidays? Then they may say they go to the grandparents' house or they just stay back at home. Okay, when you're going here and there from this place to that, how do you travel? And then buses or cars. Now, what are the different vehicles that you can name now? Okay, how many of you have gone to a railway station? How many of you have traveled by train? How many of you have seen a train? So these kind of questions you can ask, and then finally say, when you go to a railway station, or at least you've seen in the movies or on television, what is it that generally you see there? What sounds do you hear? Then you slowly come to the railway announcement, and today I'm going to make you listen to an important announcement. See, from where we started off, from grandmother's house to railway station. So that is how you have to make your classes very lively. Okay? So don't straight away go to enter the class and say, children, now listen carefully, I'm going to make you listen to some announcement. I'll ask you a question. No, don't do that. Build a rapport. That is what I'm trying to tell you here. Make it lively, make it interesting. The child should be motivated to listen to you. All right. And then when you're talking about while listening, here the actual listening is taking place. The teacher is reading, or teacher is narrating, or teacher is playing the audio. Now, just like I played the audio here, you can play the audio. And the students are going to listen carefully. You can even give them some worksheets, okay? The worksheet could be of simple multiple choice questions. So you can have simple short questions, multiple choice questions, yes or no questions, underlining one word, okay? And don't give them the text. If you give the text, what happens? They'll start reading the text. Then you're not developing listening comprehension, you are developing reading comprehension. And don't ask long answer questions also, because when you ask such questions, what will the children do? They'll start writing long answer and they will miss out the information. So as they're listening, they have to just write ticking or underlining. And the question should be arranged sequentially, chronologically. Okay? Otherwise, the information will be jumping from last line up. Beginning is at the end of the question there. That should not happen. I hope you're all able to understand. And at the post-listening stage, keep jotting down. As we are discussing, as I'm giving you the points, you can go on jotting down these points so that you implement them in the classes. So simple multiple choice questions, you can have factual, quickly write down. To the point, whatever is there in the text, you're going to ask them. Then, it's simple, it has to be chronological, proper sequence. This is for the while listing. And when you're coming to the post-listing stage, you can have any kind of question. You're going to develop higher order skills here. So higher order questions. Analytical, just jot down, analytical. Inferential. Prediction.
Ma'am, could you please repeat the second one? Could you please repeat second one, ma'am?
Inferential. Inference, you, making inference. Analytical, analysis, prediction. Then, hypothetical. These kind of questions you should ask. And then you can also you can make them play skit. Okay, role play, skit, debate, you can conduct interview. All this you can do at the post-listening stage. So this is the main difference here. While listening, you're giving very, very simple questions. Whereas post-listening, you are asking all these different kinds of questions. Okay? You can even give them jumbled order questions here. And then afterwards, they can rearrange the sentences. But you can't do that during the while listening stage. Jumbled order. I hope you're able to follow. So rearrange all those kinds of questions together. Now, what are the questions we discussed here? You can even have a quiz.
You are now unmuted. You are now muted.
What?
You are now unmuted. You are now muted. You are now unmuted.
Zoom out. Now we can see. Yeah, you can just take a screenshot there.
You are now muted.
So these are the different kinds of questions you can ask. So pre-listening, it is all introduction. While listening, simple questions. The factual question, the simple chronologically arranged, easy to understand. And post listening, you are asking them higher order questions. You are rearranging, making them rearrange, reorder. You can ask them analytical question, prediction, hypothetical, then skit, debate, interview. All these things you can ask them. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now your task for today will be you're going to frame questions for this particular listening comprehension. Now this activity that you, railway announcement that you just heard, you're going to prepare some pre-listening questions or discussion. You will also write some questions for while listening, simple chronological factual question. And you will also write questions for the post-listening stage, some higher order question. Like, what do you think would have happened? What do you think you would have done? Why do you think? So this why these kind of questions, I want to hear more. Will you write that? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that
will be your task.
More tasks that I've given you. You're going to prepare some pre-listening activities only for this particular railway announcement. I hope you've listened to it. Okay? You don't have to write the answers. So don't worry. Any kind of question you can ask, you don't worry about the answer. Even if the train number, if you've forgotten, no problem. If you've forgotten the name of the train, no problem. But you know what information was given, isn't it? It is about the delay of a train. It has to come from, instead of that time, some other time, and some platform, okay? And name of the train was mentioned, then number of the train was mentioned. So you just prepare questions and see how best you can work here. Pre-listing what kind of discussion you can have with the children. So from now onwards, when you enter a class and you're going to make give them some activity for listening comprehension, now you will be focusing on all these stages. That is what I'm trying to bring your attention to. So you're going to make them work at the pre-listening level, at the while listening level, at the post-listening level. Okay? Now, what activities we conducted, the quiz and all that, that was at the post-listening, isn't it? We didn't do anything at the while listening, isn't it? Did you get that?
Yes.
We didn't have
anything
at the while listening. We only did post-listening. Now, I'll just try to show some activity wherein there is another passage. I'll read out a story for you. For that, you're going to directly you work on the while listening part. Okay, I'll just go to the next slide. This is a story, The Weak and the Strong. Now, go through these questions. This is for the while listening stage. I hope you understood. I'll zoom out my picture. I'll just move. Okay, read the questions quickly. Now, as I'm reading the passage, you try to answer.
The mouse was tiny.
No. I said, just read quietly. If all the 77 people start reading, then who will be able to hear? Mute. After muting, maybe you can read loudly, no problem. Then you won't be disturbing anybody. Okay, now listen to the passage that I'm going to read out. And in our book, you just jot down the answers. All right. The weak and the strong. Once upon a time, okay, are you all able to hear? One person say yes or no?
Yes,
yeah.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, thank you. Okay, mute. Once upon a time, if you want, you can record, no problem. Once upon the weak and the strong. Once upon a time, there lived an elephant. He was proud of his strength. One morning, he saw a tiny mouse sitting inside a hole in the ground. The elephant called out, "Come out, oh tiny friend, let's play and have fun." The mouse came out. Suddenly, the elephant caught the tiny mouse by his tail and hung him upside down. "Ha ha ha, that's how I want to have fun," jeered the elephant. The poor mouse was frightened. He somehow freed himself and ran inside. A few days later, the mouse saw the elephant passing that way. He slowly came out of his hole and began to follow the elephant. At one place, the elephant paused for a while. The mouse jumped upon the elephant's leg and bit him with his sharp teeth. "Ah," cried the elephant. "That is how I wish to have fun," said the mouse, and quickly ran inside his hole. Okay. Did you all hear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
I hope it was clear,
yes,
enough.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Now tell me the answers. The mouse was dash.
Tiny.
The mouse was tiny.
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 Tiny. Tiny.
The mouse lived in the
hole.
The elephant
dashed
for a while.
Paused for a while.
What's the difference between pause and stop?
It's a small
stopping for a while.
Stopping
for a while.
The mouse jumped upon the
leg of the elephant.
The elephant followed the mouse as his
friend.
Mouse as his tiny friend. Okay. Now this is about the wild listener. Now when you move to the previous slide that I had written for you,
ma'am,
I told you the wild listening question should be multiple choice, okay? Fill in the blanks, ticking. So this is done. Are they all factual questions? Answers are given in the passage? Yes, ma'am?
Factual.
Yes.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Are the questions simple?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, simple questions.
Are they arranged chronologically?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
One after the other?
Yes,
yes, yes. Very good. Okay. Now,
but do we have
let
to
us
ask
try
them
to look at the post-listening stage. So what kind of questions can we ask here?
High-order questions.
Yes. Frame a question. Now you frame a question.
Where do you think the mouse lives?
Okay, where do you think? They said they live in the forest, right?
Okay.
Why is the elephant proud of?
Elephants get
why is the elephant proud of?
What was it proud of?
Why did the elephant
make fun? What would you do if you are in the place of mouse?
Mouse, very mouse. Good.
Name some animals in the forest.
How did the elephant...
Regarding this, first you talk about the passage. So different kinds of questions related to the passage. Then you can move on. What are the other animals and all that?
Okay. Why did the mouse eat the...
Why did the elephant...
Will you also feel proud if you are elephant?
Okay.
What else do you think the mouse could have done?
Okay, very good. So all of you are thinking in a different way here. I really appreciate that. Now let us quickly see here. What was the elephant proud of? Strength?
Strong
why did
body.
Strength. Now, answer. Why did the elephant call out to the mouse?
To make fun of it.
to make okay. fun.
No, to have, yeah, to have fun. He didn't want to make fun of his toddler, but he wanted to enjoy.
Let's have fun.
So, how did the elephant have fun with the mouse?
So it hung up the mouse with its tail.
Tail.
By tail, and then it made the scream. How did the mouse have fun with the elephant? Now this is Uta.
By
the
biting,
mouse had fun by biting the leg of the elephant.
By biting.
Leg and biting it. Okay. Now who is strong in this passage?
Mice.
Mouse.
Mouse. Mouse.
The mouse.
Mouse.
The mouse.
Biting.
Though it is small in size, it is
strong. Both are. It frightened the. Frightened the elephant.
Yeah. Now all of you mute for a minute. Just mute. Very good. Yes. Please mute. All of you mute. Yes. Now when you observe the questions here, these are all factual questions, simple questions arranged one after the other. Right. Whereas when you're talking about post-listening, you can ask any kind of question because now they're not listening. Now they've already finished listening. They're just answering out of whatever they have understood. So you are making the child speak, even if the answer is big. Now, any kind of question here, who is strong? Some children may say the mouse is strong. Some may say the elephant is strong. Because if you're talking about the strength, it could be anything here. So any answer you can accept because the answer is not mentioned in the passage. Okay. So your interpretation may be different from your student's interpretation. But only thing is that you have to give them a lot of questions and make them speak. Don't just stick to these kind of questions. These questions are fine to test their listening ability. But don't stop at that. Don't ask them question number one is from here to there, second from here to there. You have to make go beyond the text. Ask them, why do you think the elephant called only the mouse? It didn't call anyone else. So you should make trigger their imagination now. Then maybe it could be the reason that, yeah, well, now you tell me, one of you tell me, why did the elephant call only to the mouse and no other animal here in the forest?
Because
just to prove that he is stronger than.
Yes,
he
is stronger. That's one point. Any other point?
To have fun.
The elephant thought the mouse is the inferior.
To scare the mouse.
Which it is the smallest animal.
Smallest animal. Well, only the devil can show.
And that two rat cannot revolt. Revolt yes. against it.
So it was underestimating its strength. See, these kind of
to satisfy
all answers are correct, isn't it? Just mute.
To satisfy ego.
Yes, to satisfy ego. Very good. Now, all of you mute. See, all the answers that each one of you has given is correct. So I can't say you are wrong, only you are right. All answers are correct, but we should make the children speak. Encourage the children to answer. All right? So this is what we need to do. And you can also say that the elephant must have played these kind of funny things with the other elephants, but now all other elephants have boycotted him. They are tired of his funny behavior. So now he wanted to go and play with some smaller animals. So that also could be the answer. Then you can ask anything about the real life. Children, have you come across any human being like this, any of your friend who is trying to bully you, or bully some other small children in the school? So these kind of questions you should make them speak, okay? And then ask them about the new title. Somebody said naughty elephant, egoistic elephant, all right, or strong mouse, give a different title. All this you can do that. At the end, you can even have a small skit of the elephant and the mouse. And you can even, since you're dealing with high school children, you can also ask them some questions like, come on, you can think a little beyond, think before that. Before the elephant came and called the mouse, maybe you can have a kind of a discussion where the elephant is calling other animals and they all refuse. So you can extend the skit a little further and make it more interesting. Okay, so all elephants said, no, 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 we don't want to play with you. Then finally he starts going, those big fat feet, legs, and then finally thinks, okay, let me try playing or having fun with the mouse. That is how he ended up with this kind of a thought. This kind of thoughts you can have, this kind of skits you can have in the class. All right. So will you change the way you have been doing? Some of you may have already been doing, but some of you may still need some kind of a different orientation to how to conduct a listening comprehension class. Okay. So it is not just listen to something, answer, listen, answer. There are three different stages. You have to plan each stage and make it interesting. All right. So when you see the passage, it is only this much, but you can have one whole hour just dedicated for that. Different stages, you can do different things. Is it fine now? Yes. So now no more questions about what task you have to do. Every time after our session ends, the next day morning, you just dedicate your time to try to write down questions or answers or reflect upon whatever the previous day's session had given you. Okay? You don't have to put it in the group, but we can have a discussion later when we meet again. And then the next point is about the pretest. Deepa and anybody else who has not taken the pretest, you will be taking it at 4:30. I hope things are clear now. And on Saturday,